Well, hello, I'm Elijah Martin, and I'm starting my second year as a student, a UCSF student. I study developmental and stem cell biology. And actually, as a student, I work here at the Gladstone Institutes, which is a UCSF-affiliated institution, but all the students at the Gladstone come from UCSF. So specifically, I work here at the Cardiovascular Institute, and I'm interested in morphogenesis, the formation of the heart, and how that might go bad in disease. So I grew up in DC area, Maryland, to be specific. And my dad works in public health area, science, as does my mom. And so early on, I had a sort of knack for science. No, I never really thought I really wanted to be a scientist. I always knew I liked working with my hands, and I took some biology classes early on, and I kind of liked it, and I was good at it. And so with that, somebody older than me encouraged me to check out research and thought that that sort of combination of skills might be good for doing research. And so from there, I did the research experience at the end of high school and been with it ever since. I really liked it. So I'm sort of at the beginning, figuring out what I'm doing, but if I could describe it, I'd say I'm interested in studying how the heart forms and how it gets the structure it has to do the job it needs to do. And studying when that goes bad, what happens, and why does it go bad. So really all about how the heart forms and how it has its structure. And I think that if you know sort of the basic science behind it, sort of what's going on when it's going regularly, then that informs how you might want to go about fixing things when they do go wrong. I really knew I really wanted to study stem cell biology just because there's a lot of public papers published about some of the promise of stem cell biology, such as by Shinya Yamanaka, Nobel laureate for doing iPS cells. And so that kind of got me interested in stem cell biology. I really knew that I was interested in working towards disease. And so Gladstone has a big emphasis on solving problems that are directly related to solving disease in patients. And so ever since my first research experience, I was exposed to that sort of research. And so it was a really natural fit. So a big obstacle for me was figuring out really what's my passion and what do I really want to do. And to overcome that, I really just had to have a lot of different experiences in a lot of different areas and fields. And then doing all that made me realize, coming back to where I started actually, that research is the thing for me. So, well, I do sort of have a passion for giving back and helping others and with education. So I guess my greatest achievement would be sort of encouraging other people to go down the path that I've gone through. By just going back and talking to students that are younger, and just by showing them an example that, you know, I'm me and you can do what I do also. So by inspiring other people, I say that's probably my greatest achievement.